Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Civil Engineering Education. Today I am back with another topic on earthwork calculations. So earthwork calculations also most important calculations which we come across in all type of structures. So it may be any kind of structure, it may be road, building or canal work, whatever it may be, we come across earthwork calculations in all type of works. So this is the important calculation, so don't skip the video in middle, watch the video till end. And if you are new to the channel, do subscribe. And if you like my videos, hit the like button so that it will be more encouraging for me. So let us start. So in civil engineering point of view, we come across various structures. It may be roads, buildings, canals, bridges or whatever may be the structure. So we come across different types of structures in our day-to-day life. So in every structure, we come across the earthwork calculation, which is the most important calculation. So let us see what are the structures we come across. In all the civil engineering structures such as roads, buildings, bridges, canals, culverts, dams, etc. requires earthwork. So for all these types of structures, we need to do the calculation for earthwork. Earthwork may be above ground level or below ground level, whatever it may be, but we should do the earthwork calculations as a part of our duty. So here, quantity of earthwork. So to calculate the quantity of earthwork, it can be in cutting or it can be in filling. So if the earthwork is done above the ground level, here you can see the figure. So this is ground level. If the earthwork is done below the ground level, that is called cutting. And if the earthwork is done above the ground level, that is called embankment. So earthwork in cutting is called excavation. Earthwork in filling is called embankment. So these are the two important terms which we need to understand first. So if the earthwork is done above the ground level, we call it as embankment. If the earthwork is done below the ground level, we call it as cutting or excavation. So an estimate of earthwork involves in calculation of volume of earthwork and lead and lift. So in estimate of earthwork, when we are doing the estimates of earthworks, we come across these two important terms, that is volume of earthwork, second one is lead and lift. So that should be understood properly. So volume of earthwork, what is volume of earthwork? Volume of earthwork is nothing but it is calculated by multiplying the cross-sectional area and length. If you see this figure, this is a trapezoidal shape. So for this trapezoidal shape, this is the length. How to find the volume for this trapezoidal figure? So first of all, we need to find the area of this hatched portion and we have to multiply with the length so that we will get the volume. I have written the formula here, volume is equal to area into length, so that we will get total quantity of earthwork. So in earthwork, it is simply we can say that volume is equal to cross-sectional area into length will give us the quantity, that is nothing but volume. It is denoted by the letter V. Volume is denoted by the letter V and its units are in cubic meter. So earthwork is calculated in cubic meters, that we need to know. Next one is calculation of volumes can be done by any one method. So earthwork calculations can be done by these three different methods. So first one is from cross sections. So cross sections is nothing but, so here I have already explained, this is the cross section. If we multiply the cross sectional area with length, we will get the volume, that is from cross sectional figures. Next one is from spot levels. Spot levels also we can calculate. Next one is from contour levels. So these are the three important types of calculations which we come across in calculating the volume of earthwork. So we will understand these all very clearly in the further coming videos. While doing the problems, I am going to explain you in detail. Now let us understand what is lead, what is lift and what are the standard values we use here. So what is lead? It is the horizontal distance between centroid of excavation and embankment is called lead. That is nothing but this is the horizontal distance whichever is covered for earthwork is called lead. So if you observe this figure, this is ground level, this is earthwork done below ground level and this is earthwork done above ground level. So this is actual ground level. So this is the centroid of excavation. This is the centroid of embankment. So we will draw this vertical lines like this, and we will measure the distance. So whatever the distance we covered between these two centroids, this is called a lead. So it is nothing but horizontal distance between centroid of excavation to centroid of embankment is called lead. What are the standard values? How we will take number of leads? So initially we will take 10 meter as one lead, and for every additional 10 meters or part we will calculate another lead. For example, if earthwork carried over a distance of 25 meters, so it is carried over a distance of 25 meters, so how many leads we will come across? So total 3 leads we will come across, because initial is 10 meters, additional is 10 meters, and remaining is 5. This is 1, 2 and 3. Here it is written, initial lead is 10 meters, that is 1, additional lead is 10 meters, that is 2, additional lead is 5 meters, that is 3. Total 3 leads we come across. Next one is lift. So same like lead, lead is horizontal distance, lift is vertical distance. So this is the centroid vertical distances. So this is the centroid of excavation, centroid of embankment. The vertical distance whichever we covered is called lift. It is the vertical distance between centroid of excavation and embankment. What are the standard values? So same like lead, initially we will take 2 meters for lift. So first we will take 2 meters. For every additional 1 meter or part, we will take another lift. For example, if the earthwork carried to a height of 3.8 meters. So 3.8 meters is this height. How many lifts we come across? So initially you can see here, initial lift is taken as 2 meters, which is given here. Additionally, we need to take 1 meter as the extra lift. So initial lift is 2 meter, additional lift is 1 meter, additional lift is 0.8 meter. We can split like this, 2 plus 1 plus 0.8. So that means total 3 lifts we come across. So in this way we are going to calculate the lead and lift. So this is most important in paying the amount to the contractor. So I hope you understood. In the further videos I am going to cover the calculations for this lead and lift. So stay tuned, and if you like my videos, hit the like button, and if you are new to the channel, do subscribe. Thanks for watching.